In markets where there are multiple vendors selling the same product, a buyer's ability to compare prices prevents the same good from being sold at different prices. But what happens when this process of comparison shopping is costly, and consumers either can't or choose not to search for the lowest price? This paper explores the impact of costly search in a market where the consequences of price dispersion are potentially very high, the consumer debt market. In particular, they focus on auto loans, with over 106 million outstanding loans totaling $1.15 trillion in aggregate. Auto debt is the fastest growing category of consumer debt in the US, smaller than only mortgages and student loans. Over 85% of car purchases are financed with a loan, and even in an age of online lending, this market remains surprisingly local. The median borrower in this paper's sample uses a lender located within just a 15-minute drive of home. To what extent is price dispersion a problem in this market? Are similar borrowers paying different interest rates for the same loan? To answer this question, the authors use an administrative dataset covering 2.4 million loans extended by 326 different financial institutions in all 50 states. They group borrowers together if they live in the same commuting zone, took out a loan in the same 6-month transaction window, and are similar on a number of dimensions, including their credit score. Thus, each group consists of similar borrowers taking out the same loan at the same time and in the same geographic market. And yet, the authors find that 54% of borrowers are paying a higher interest rate than the one paid by another member of their group. In other words, the majority of borrowers are not getting their best available rate. The authors estimate that the average borrower in these data pays an interest rate that is 1.3 percentage points higher than the lowest rate available to them. So, why does this price dispersion exist? Are borrowers not getting the best available rate because it is too difficult or too costly to shop around for it? To investigate this question, the authors exploit a particular feature of this market: the fact that some lenders employ discontinuous pricing rules. To illustrate, this figure corresponds to a single lender in their data. Each point corresponds to the average interest rate this lender offered to borrowers in the corresponding credit score bin, and the resulting pattern maps out a pricing rule with clear and substantial jumps in interest rates at credit scores of 600, 660, and 700. This means, for example, that a borrower with a credit score of 599 is offered an interest rate that is 2.5 percentage points higher than an equivalent borrower whose credit score is just 1 point higher at 600. These pricing rules are not unique to this particular lender, and their existence across many others gives rise to similar discontinuities in the aggregate. This figure draws from a sample of over 550,000 loans from 57 institutions with similar pricing policies, and shows that here, as well, borrowers just on either side of the 600-point cutoff receive significantly different interest rates. This is notable given that the kinds of characteristics that lenders typically look at in order to determine interest rates, including the debt-to-income ratio, loan amount, and applicant age, gender, and ethnicity, don't actually differ in any meaningful way on either side of the threshold. Despite being very similar borrowers, those on either side of the credit score threshold receive very different interest rates purely because of these arbitrary pricing rules. Now, in the context of this paper, these discontinuities are useful because they provide quasi-random variation in the potential benefits of searching for another loan. Not all lenders use the same pricing policies, or even have discontinuous pricing rules at all, and this implies that a borrower who lies just to the left of a discontinuity at one lender can potentially receive a better interest rate if she simply searches for another loan in her local market. And indeed, the authors show that there is a meaningful difference in the potential benefits of searching for another loan for borrowers on either side of the discontinuity. This next figure plots the difference between the interest rate a borrower pays and the lowest available rate to a borrower of the same type in the same market. In other words, the spread to the lowest available rate. For borrowers just to the right of a credit score threshold, The density of this spread is concentrated close to zero, indicating that most borrowers are already receiving close to their best available rate. But those just to the left of a threshold exhibit much higher average spreads, indicating that the potential benefits of searching for another offer are high. And correspondingly, the authors show that these left-of-threshold borrowers are less likely to accept the offered loan, presumably because they decide to search for a better offer. Crucially, however, they also find that these borrowers' propensity to search is lower in geographic markets where there are few lending institutions within a 20-minute drive. In other words, in markets where the cost of searching for another loan is high. In low search cost areas, borrowers who receive a relatively expensive loan offer are 13.7 percentage points more likely to engage in additional search relative to those who received a good offer. In high search cost areas, however, this difference shrinks to only 2 percentage points. Altogether, these results suggest that search costs restrict borrowers' ability to obtain their best available rate in the market for auto loans, and this friction allows price dispersion to persist. Importantly, the authors show that this dispersion has very real consequences for borrowers. Those who are offered and accept high interest rates because they lie just to the left of a pricing threshold end up purchasing less expensive and older cars than they otherwise would have, and using less financing in their purchase. Overall, this paper highlights the degree to which, even in an era of online lending, search for consumer credit products remains an opaque, local, and costly process for many borrowers, and shows that the price dispersion arising from these frictions can constrain and distort borrowers' consumption choices. To read more on this topic, you can check out the full paper and its references to other related research. These include papers exploring the implications of costly search and price dispersion in a variety of different markets, research studying how credit market frictions in general affect consumption, and finally, a growing literature examining these issues specifically in the context of auto loans.